Hello, Sky is here, and today we have a bit of an exotic topic. Let's leave a big and famous aircraft manufacturers for today and go for a walk. For a walk through the Mojave Desert in California. Come to think of it, what do we want to find in this endless sea of a desert sand? But the knowing people will immediately remember that Mojave is not a simple desert. One of the largest test air bases of the United States, Edwards, is here. Also, a little town called Palmdale, and near it, a famous secret division of the Lockheed Martin Skunk Works. A famous secret division, If we ride deeper into the desert, we will find one more interesting place. Welcome to the Mojave Air and Spaceport. Yes, yes, the FAA classifies this place specifically as a spaceport. This place is a real mecca for all aerospace junkies. Here you can find the facilities of BAE Systems, Northrop Grumman, Scaled Composites, and many more smaller private companies. And here, on May 21st, 2017, from a lonely hangar on the spaceport's outskirts, this was rolled out. Honestly, at first it seemed to me as a virtual 3D model for flight simulator. Then, I thought it was the result of marijuana legalization in California. But it's a fact, this thing is real and soon it should take off. So, what is it and who is guilty of its creation? Let's throw our nets into these strange waters. Stratolaunch Model 351, nicknamed ROC, is an aviation platform developed by Scaled Composites to provide airborne launch of carrier rockets. The history of the Stratolaunch project began in 2011, when Microsoft co-founder Paul Allen and founder of Scaled Composites Bert Rutan officially announced the creation of the Stratolaunch Systems Corporation. The task of the new company was the development and operation of air transport systems, as well as launching space vehicles by them. The Stratolaunch project is the unity of three main components: the aircraft launch platform, which will be developed by Scaled Composites, the carrier rocket that will be launched from this aircraft, and the flight and launch control system developed by the Dynetics company. Soon it was announced that SpaceX is joining the venture. SpaceX was supposed to create the rocket. However, the cooperation with Elon Musk's company was interrupted in 2012. SpaceX came to a conclusion that the Stratolaunch doesn't fit into their long-term plans and decided to concentrate resources on the Falcon program. In 2012, the recently created Stratolaunch Systems built an assembly site in the Mojave spaceport. That is a large hangar and the composite elements production line. The plane was publicly presented this year, on May 21st. By the end of the year, it is planned to make a maiden flight. The first launch of the rocket from Stratolaunch is planned in 2019. The commercial launches should start around 2020. Okay, let's look closer on this exotic device. The aircraft is created by the Scaled Composites and has two fuselages located side by side and connected by one wing. The scheme is similar to other Bert Rutan's creations, White Knight and White Knight 2, which were created for Richard Branson's space travel company, Virgin Galactic. By the way, British billionaire doesn't work in Mojave. He built his own spaceport in Arizona. Each of two fuselages is 73 meters long and equipped with a landing gear with 14 wheels, main gear with 12 wheels, and two on a nose gear. The plane also has separate tails. The horizontal tail of the two fuselages are not connected, because if they were, the stabilizer would be inside the aerodynamic wind shadow of the rocket. It could destabilize the aircraft during a flight. The fuselages are connected by a straight and high aspect ratio wing. The Stratolaunch Model 351 has the largest wingspan in aviation history, 117 meters. Hughes H4 has 97.5 meters, and Antonov N225 has 88.4 meters. The central wing section, located between two fuselages, has significantly increased structural strength, and it is designed not only to provide structural rigidity to the plane, but also to handle over 230 tons of load. The aircraft is equipped with 6 Pratt & Whitney PW4056 engines. Those engines are popular in commercial aviation and, for example, are mounted on the wings of Boeing 747 and Airbus A330. Stratolaunch inherited many elements and systems from Jumbo. In addition to engines, it received a significant share of avionics, the cockpit, the landing gear and other systems. Due to this solution, Stratolaunch systems had the opportunity to cut the cost of the development. Actually, the aircraft didn't just inherit the elements, it took them directly from Jumbo. During the assembly of Stratolaunch, two old United Airlines Boeing 747-400s were dismantled. Initially, the rocket was supposed to be developed by SpaceX, but the guys from LA left the project. Instead, Stratolaunch Systems contacted the Orbital ATK. This corporation is working in aerospace industry, creating the solid propellant boosters for NASA SLS Heavy Launch Vehicle, and also produces the Cygnus cargo vehicles that fly to the International Space Station. Orbital ATK was supposed to create the Pegasus 2 solid propellant medium rocket, but this project was too expensive. As a result, at the first time, Stratolaunch will launch the existing Pegasus XL rocket. These light vehicles are already being launched by the Lockheed L-1011 aircraft. Pegasus XL has 23 tons of mass and is able to carry 443 kilograms of payload into low Earth orbit. Moreover, it is planned that Stratolaunch will be able to launch three such rockets during one flight. After some time, a new heavier class rocket will be created, and potentially it will be capable to realize even manned flights with the Dream Chaser space plane. Stratolaunch flight range is 3,700 kilometers, not impressive, but enough to take off from the Mojave spaceport, reach the launch position over the Pacific Ocean at the altitude of 11 kilometers, launch a vehicle and return to base. According to calculations, it will allow to effectively carry payloads into the various orbits. Despite the impressive size, Stratolaunch is a world leader only in terms of the wingspan. The weight of carrying payload is impressive, 230 tons. But it is nevertheless 20 tons less than the Antonov 225. And of course, the main awesomeness indicator, the maximum takeoff weight. Here, Antonov still holds the title of super heavy plane. 640 tons against 590 tons of the Stratolaunch. So, Stratolaunch is quite curious machine with an interesting potential. The idea of airborne space vehicle launching is not new, but no one has reached such scale before. It will be interesting to watch if they succeed in this venture or not. Today, for the first time, I touched not only the aircrafts, but also a little bit of space. The channel is about sky, which you know is infinite. So, I'll be coming back to it sometimes. Don't worry about airplanes, there's still a lot of them on the way. That's the story for today. Subscribe to the channel and comment below what do you think about all of it. Bright stars, fast flights and soft landings to you.